Good morning, fans of Privateer FX. Coming at you at the European Open, 4th of June. Risk on overnight, even though the trade talks with China are ongoing. Lots of sticks and stones being thrown. If the dollar is marginally weaker and stocks are marginally higher, the big winner overnight was Aussie. Retail sales beat last night, so now we're above 76 to figure. We're clearing into this sort of clear air area. We're not going to chase the Aussie here at 76.15, but weaker dollar, risk on, this is going to benefit the commodity currencies, as is generally expected. Today we have UK PMI construction, and we got factory orders and durable goods in the US, so sort of second-rate stuff. The charts that are most important, I think, are the sterling charts. Here's Euro Sterling, big bearish engulf. On Friday, no one was watching Euro Sterling because it was non-farms. We like this to continue lower and break these lows sometime this week. 87 the figure, and then 86.80. There could easily be a story applied to this, you know, all this bullshit going on in Europe and Spain and Italy and trade. G7's meeting Quebec this weekend, and Europe is squawking about U.S. trade. We could get some more negative euro flow, and there could be sort of a little halo around the sterling, ironically, because they... the market may just go, oh, look, they were smart to leave the euro. Whether that makes sense or not, it's not really the point. Looks like the market is putting this trade on, and the positioning is neutral, so we like this lower. Cable also, we think, is a buy. Tough now. You know, 62 is that high. On Friday, I don't know where to leave the stop on this. This is the problem. So I mean, 133.40. I don't know. Cable's a tough one when you're fading it, and it's gonna get sloppy. Construction index at 10:30 today. That's probably not gonna be that great. Not sure. We want to get long sterling, really against the basket, sterling yen also, push short this stuff, through the highs, not really, it's not really a great setup, it's already up a third of a percent, tough, sterling Swiss maybe, less ball probably, but we're going to stick with Euro Sterling. Basically, we're going to be selling Euro Sterling sort of here at 45, up to 65 today, which was the breakdown. Stops will be above 80, and then we will add through the lows, Friday's lows, which were 87.26. The other chart that's decent and has been lagging on this risk on is CAD yen. Talk about in these circumstances, often commodity currencies are chosen. CAD yen through the figure, 85 a figure looks decent. Got these highs here, and it's also a pivot, and there's really no resistance up here between 85 and 87, so we do like CAD yen higher. How this is reflected, I don't know. Low on Friday in dollar CAD, 129.30. The low today, 129.30. Maybe you start your visit into CAD yen longs if 30 breaks. The problem with 30 is we had that really, really sweet break up through 129, the figure, on Thursday. So there's going to be support here between figure and 30. So this, I don't think, is a break trade, but could be the beginning of a CAD/YEN move, maybe. So a little bit offbeat today. CAD/YEN right hand side, euro sterling left hand side. We'll watch the news flow as always for more nonsense out of Europe. And I guess you got to keep the Twitter feed up. Check out what old Trumpy Bumpy's going to say starting at around 3:30, 4 a.m. Eastern time. We got a new book this week, 10% Happier by Dan Harris. A little bit less on the technology and trading and business, and more on the lifestyle. But of course, being a good trader, part of being a good trader is being happy. We all trade best when we're front foot and we're happy. So have a look. 10% Happier by Dan Harris. Cool. Good luck today on this first Monday in June. I will see you guys at the European Open.